episode 14 of Dice Up, the video podcast for female masters. I'm Rogue.
And I'm Carrie. Nice to see you guys again. We have a good show this time. Rogue's going to do a segment on mask hygiene. I have an interview with the youngest master we ever had on the show. And later on, I'm going to recreate an old black and white movie. But first, I want to do a little editorial. In the United States lately, politicians have been taking aim at trans kids and drag queens and passing some pretty draconian laws, all in the name of protecting the children. I've seen this all before. Used to be comic books, and rock and roll, and then video games, and MTV, and the internet. All these things were going to destroy the youth of America. So these opportunistic politicians here are punching down, picking on people who can't fight back, like the trans community and drag queens. But those politicians are wrong. They're wrong like the people were in the 1960s who were against civil rights. You know, there's nothing wrong with being a trans kid or doing drag or wanting to watch drag. So I say to you that this will pass as well. Just stay strong, maybe move on to a red state, and hopefully they'll move on to somebody else. So, but we support you.
That's true. I would love to ask some of these people what their definition of freedom is and how their actions work against that definition. And also, if you want me to respect your rights, you have to respect my rights. That's the way it works.
Yeah, we can't be taking rights away from people either. Certainly not from just protecting the children. Meanwhile, stay tuned to the end of the episode and we'll have a special announcement too.
We like to begin each show with a catch-up on what we've been doing recently that we call Fess Up. So, Carrie, it's been a bit. How you been and what you been working on?
Well, normally I have nothing new to say, but I'm in a full robe this time and I've got lots of news. For starters, I have a new mask. This is a Reiner Jane mask. I saw somebody using one in a camp session, and I said, what is it? This is a Jane. I said, I love it. I want to buy it. And I bought it right on the spot. I've also been making new cosplays for the first time in, like, 20 years. You'll see one of them later on in the show here. And this dress is just something I picked up in a local department store. I thought it looked like a nice, fun summer dress there. And then Rogue suggested that I add a belt. Also dragged out my old Spider-Woman outfit, and I wore it in March at the Emerald City Comic Con here in Seattle. There's me riding the escalator down at the convention center there.
Now, did you hear there's going to be a Spider-Woman movie? It's not going to be Jessica Drew, but they have announced that they're working on one.
Yeah, the diehard Jess fans wanted Jess Spider-Woman movie, and I guess they're calling Spider-Gwen Spider-Woman in the new movie? In case you're wondering why I'm a black Spider-Woman, go see Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, and you will see that Jessica Drew is a black Spider-Woman in that movie. Definitely diehard old 20th century Jessica Drew Spider-Woman fans would love to see a Jessica Drew being it. There was hopes that the Khaleesi there was going to be playing Jessica Drew in one of these Marvel shows, but she's playing a different character completely. But hope springs eternal. Anyway, Rogue, what have you been up to?
Well, first, this outfit that I'm wearing is based on a show that Carrie and I both enjoy called The Venture Brothers. You might recognize Dr. Girlfriend as the arch-nemesis' Moll in that show. And in this particular outfit, she had married the Monarch and became Dr. Mrs. the Monarch. And I think it's a fun outfit. I did not make this one, but I did improve it a bit and just enjoyed wearing Dr. Girlfriend outfits. I have had a second one that I made, which was her pink outfit that was very 60s looking. And that one I featured on a previous episode. Here's an image of that. I also worked on a white Greek-inspired outfit just for kicks. I wanted the outfit and thought it would be fun to make. Also, this black dress with a high slit up the side. And I don't know if you know this, Carrie, but I'm also a fan of playing tennis.
I did not know that.
I've been playing for years. I even got my daughter involved. A friend and I also competed in a local convention. There is an artist locally who created an image very reminiscent of the Rocket Girls, Flash Gordon type serials that came out a long time ago. And my friend and I thought it would be fun to recreate the outfits from that image. So I did this girl on the right, the Rocket Girl. And we competed on stage and did quite well. We won Best in Show for presentation and just had fun. We also showed those outfits off to the creator of the original image, and he just got a kick out of seeing his 2D image turned into 3D art. It was a fun challenge, too, to figure out some of the engineering behind making the rocket pack, for sure. You know, I've done that in the past for other artists, and they are just super excited when they see someone who takes their art and creates art from it. I think that could really understand how excited they would be to see that.
Yeah, I got to see them there. They look pretty great. Next segment is Heads Up. Hello?
Hello, Carrie. Hello, Rogue. I'm Megan.
We know, Megan. You were in a famous movie this year. What are you doing here?
I wanted to show you how some of my movie was made using female silicone masks. As you can see, they feature my face several times in the movie, including putting it on my robot body. What's interesting is that my face did not come with hair. But later in the movie, you can clearly see punched hair in the silicone. Oh well. We made the movie with some puppets, but also with a real young actress wearing my face for certain scenes, as you can see in this behind-the-scenes video.
That was very entertaining, Megan. Thank you for sharing that with us.
My pleasure, Carrie and Rogue. Thank you for having me on your show. I hope we can be best friends forever and ever. Okay, bye.
Wow, okay. Carrie, what did she see this time?
My example of masking in the media goes way back to one of the earliest female mask scenes I've seen, the 1947 Republic serial, The Black Widow. Not breakfast cereal. Serials were multi-chapter thrillers that you would catch on Saturday mornings at the cinema, usually in 12, 10-minute episodes that would end with a literal cliffhanger, which you'd have to wait a week to see how the hero got out of it. The Indiana Jones movies are a direct descendant of these old movie serials. They just do it as one big movie rather than spreading it out over 12 weeks. In The Black Widow, we follow Sombra, a mistress of disguise, trying to help her father conquer America. She wears a series of mask disguises, but because this was a low-budget production in 1947, her masking scenes were always done by simply going out of focus. In this scene, the good guys think they've arrested Sombra and show up at her psychic business.
I'm glad to see you again. What brings you here, Mr. Colt?
Why, just a routine checkup for the district attorney's office. May I see your license to operate?
Certainly.
Thank you. I'm sorry to have bothered you.
Fell for it.
And why not?
Thank you, Trixie. You did very well.
It was a pleasure. Call me anytime you've got a cinch job like that.
That's good stuff there. I kind of wonder how much these mask scenes inspired the ones that we see decades later on TV shows and movies. No, now a segment we call Makeup, where we give you tips about masking. Rogue, what do you have for us this time?
This time I wanted to discuss mask hygiene. I know it's kind of a gross subject, but it's important for your health and the health of your mask.
You might have heard the expression, rode hard and put away wet. If you think about the condition of your mask or bodysuit after you use it, do you put it away wet and then use it again? You wouldn't do that with your regular clothes, so why do it with your expensive masks and bodysuits? One of the easiest ways to take care of your masks is with disposable wipes. I recommend using cleaning wipes instead of baby wipes. The reason for that is that cleaning wipes do not contain skin lotion like baby wipes normally do. Look for disinfecting wipes which contain bleach and will eliminate any harmful bacteria on your mask. After use, wipe down the inside of your mask with a disinfecting wipe before you put it away for storage. This also helps remove any undesirable odors. For the outside of the mask, I recommend using a makeup removing cloth first to remove any makeup you may have used, and then follow that up with a disinfecting wipe. If you leave makeup on your mask for an extended period of time, there's a possibility the makeup may permeate the silicone and stain it permanently. I also put a dryer sheet in the container where I store my mask to keep it smelling fresh. Bodysuits are another challenge, but they also require the same level of care. You should consider washing them regularly in a bathtub using clean, hot water and soap. Do not use the bath water that you've been bathing in, as that unclean water can be absorbed into the pores of the silicone and not only discolor your silicone, but make it smell unpleasant too. Always use fresh, clean water. After washing, pack down the mask or bodysuit with a towel and leave it out to air dry. Do not put any silicone into a dryer, as you might end up with a permanent crease or other damage to your silicone. If you have a latex mask, be careful to avoid using anything on it that contains a petroleum-based product, including makeup. Petroleum products, which are found in most skin lotions, will literally dissolve latex over time. This is also why it's important to wash your face and body clean of any makeup or lotion before wearing a latex mask or latex clothing. Never use any soap when washing latex either, as it will strip the latex of the necessary oils, and eventually the latex will crack and split. Instead, wash latex in warm to hot water only. Warming the latex is actually good for redistributing the natural oils. So if you have a latex mask that seems to have gone hard, try washing it in warm water to return its flexibility. Following these steps will help you enjoy your silicone and latex masks longer, and you'll stay healthier too.
Well, thanks for that, Rob. That was very good information there. Definitely something you want to take care of, because you know, masks are a big investment and you want them to last a long time.
That's true, and although silicone is more durable than latex, it still requires cleaning, like anything else that you would put on your body. The next segment of our show is Show Up, and I'm excited because Carrie has created something new for us. Do you want to say anything about it before we see it, Carrie?
Well, hopefully you're paying attention during the heads-up segment because some of this will look very familiar.
I'm glad to see you again. What brings you here, Mr. Colt?
Why, just a routine checkup for the district attorney's office. May I see your license to operate?
Certainly.
Thank you. I'm sorry to have bothered you.
Fell for it.
And why not?
Thank you, Trixie. You did very well.
was a pleasure. Call me anytime you've got a cinch job like that.
Segment of our show is all dolled up, where we discuss the making of that video, and I'm here with Sombra.
Hello, I am Sombra, know-all, and see-all, and a mistress of disguise. You know I'm a psychic because I have an official certificate that says I'm a psychic.
Well, tell me about the making of that video. What inspired you to recreate this scene?
It always bugged me that how cheap the unmasking scenes looked, and I thought it would be really cool to recreate it with today's technology, but without resorting to digital effects, actually physically doing it on the screen.
What were some of the challenges you faced in making that?
Well, mainly deciding which mask to use. In the end, I used this Jane mask underneath my silicone Susan mask. But I really think I pulled it off, no pun intended.
Tell me about this outfit that you made.
Yeah, it's the first time I've done something from scratch for quite a while now. If you look at publicity photos of Sombra, it looks like she's wearing a satin dress. I really want to try to sew satin. It looks really hard. So I showed it to some friends of mine, and they said, oh, well, if you've got shiny Lycra, you could have a look just like it on camera. And I said, I do have shiny Lycra. I put it together here. The applique is actually pipe cleaners that I have bent and then stitched to the fabric here. And then I added the buttons here, and I think it turned out really great. And I want to help thank Rogue here. She worked like an hour on this wig to make it look good. She is the queen of hair, and I couldn't have done it without her.
I'm happy to help. Tell me about your choice to remove characters from the original video so you can insert yourself in. How did that happen?
Well, that goes back to 80s movies like Zelig and Dead Men Don't Wear Plaid. Interacting with old-time movie footage there, and of course with the green screen and digital effects, I was able to do that motion tracking. And it's just a sort of a fun challenge to see if I can get it in there and make it look like the old footage there. The backgrounds and the other shots are all long, still JPEGs made of strips of empty frames that I would stuck together in a long strip and then pan across and then do the actions in front of it. The professor is me wearing my mask that I originally used for the Doc Brown segment in that Back to the Future one we did several years ago.
Very cool. What fascinates you about this type of deception? Do you think we'll ever reach a point where a person could successfully disguise themselves as someone else?
I don't think so. I think because of bone structure and other things, you'll never be able to impersonate somebody else. But I do think that masks are getting really, really close to the point where you can wear one, and with the right application, you wouldn't be able to tell that person's wearing a mask, which is, you know, an incredible leap in just the last 10 years or so.
Well, thank you for sharing your video with us. It was very entertaining.
Oh, you're welcome. And I want you guys to go back to our other previous videos. And there's a little Easter egg here. There's something we've stuck in the background in a lot of different shots there. And we think it's a fun little thing to be looking for when we do our little videos.
Yeah, go back and look for that secret Easter egg in most of our videos.
Now, Talk Up, where we do an interview with someone in the masking community. This time I'm talking to Valerie.
Hi, I am Valerie Eskimedo, and I have been masking since September of 2022, and I'm 21 years old from the UK.
How did you get into masking?
Discovered it from Facebook, really. I had specific kinks, and I saw other people doing those kinks with female masks. So I sort of... the seeds were sort of planted there.
What was your first mask?
My first mask was a really rubbish one from eBay. I can't remember. I don't know the name. I think it was some sort of knockoff brand. But this second one, I got this one about a week after I got that first one. This is a May from Romania with attached breasts. And it's amazing. It's really, it's a lot of fun.
How many masks do you have?
Currently I have two masks, and I have got one on the way in CreFX Carmen. I'm really excited for that, because the whole thing with Romania, there isn't enough detail, I think. So I'm really excited to get one with more detail so I can go outside.
Well, you were the first person who's Generation Z to be on our show. What have you seen in masking in your lifetime?
Everyone is wearing masks. I see everyone is the same, and I see people trying to be as genuine as they can, and I see people trying to be trying to go for the more doll look, which I am also very interested. I love the realistic style and I love the doll styles. I see all sorts of different people trying to do different things, and I love that sort of aspect of it.
Have you met up with those maskers?
I met up with Mia Masking only a few weeks ago, and that was so much fun, and I would love to meet up with more maskers. I actually have plans to meet up with a few others in the future, and I'm really excited for that.
What do you want to do next?
So what I want to do next is I'd love to meet up with multiple maskers and just meet up with more people and experience more like different things. I definitely want to go outside of the big group of people. That would be amazing.
Well, I've seen a lot of things and changes in the last 25 years. Where do you think Female Master is going to be in 25 years from now?
Oh, I think it will be so much more realistic than it is now. I'm really excited to see how much further people can go and how genuine, how authentic people can be.
How do you think the technology is going to change? I mean, do you think masks are just going to get better and better?
I think masking will get to the point where it will be tricky to tell different people, the masks from real people. I feel like the masks will be thinner, so they move easier with your face, they hug closer to your face. Maybe even a bit more breathable. That's something that I'd love to see. I'd love to see just more detail as well. And
is there anything else you'd like to say?
Sort of a message to other maskers out there. Sometimes you might feel intimidated by other big maskers, but try not to, because they're exactly the same as you. They're doing the same hobby. Maybe they've got a few more outfits, but that doesn't mean that you can't look good in what you have. I know sometimes I feel a little bit intimidated, and I just got to remember that we're all the same. We're all doing the same hobby. We're all going for similar goals. So just have fun with it. Do what you want to do. Find your own style.
Thanks, Valerie. It's hard to believe that you and I have made movies that are older than Valerie is.
But we encourage all levels of masking, so welcome to the community.
Absolutely.
We've come to the end of another episode of Face Up, and it's time for that special announcement. Carrie?
Well, Face Up is going to go on a hiatus for a little while. But the reason is we're going to do a documentary about female masking.
Yeah, we realized that the last documentary, Secrets of the Living Dolls, that was produced by British Television, is now more than 10 years old and very out of date. You know, that came out even before silicone masks were generally available on the market.
Yeah, we're going to take you all the way back to the beginning, which is the 1940s, and talk about the different masks that have been available and some of the major players and different materials that come out and bring you right up to date. So we're trying to make this as all-encompassing as we can do it. But it's going to take us a little while, so we want you to be patient, but it will show up on our YouTube channel when we're done.
Since Carrie and I both have over 30 years of masking experience, we think we're the right people to at least research this information to present it to you. But like Carrie says, please be patient. We're hoping to release this before the end of 2024, but we are a small operation with zero funding, so we ask that you be patient.
If you want us to come back at some point, put something in the comment section below, or maybe you have a suggestion for what we should put in our documentary. We'd be happy to read about those things.
In the meantime, we'll be looking at what you're doing online, and we hope that you represent female masking well. My final bit of advice for now is if you want to be taken seriously, you have to take yourself seriously.
And if you're interested in buying a latex mask for me, go to maskon.com. And where I've been selling them since 1996. Also, I'm going to be making some personal appearances this year. At the end of August, over Labor Day weekend, I will be in Montreal, Canada, for the Montreal Fetish Weekend. And then in September, I will be at Rose City Comic Con in Portland, Oregon, where I'm going to debut a brand new cosplay. If you see me at either of these, go and say hi!
So thank you for joining us for the past 6 years. We hope to see you again. And until then, I'm Rogue.
And I'm Karen.
Thank you, and good night.